Man, we are back for part three. This is the last part of the many murders of T-Royce, Keevan, best friend, man. Shout out to Shabba Russ. Original link will be down below in the description, man. Let's go ahead and get into the video.
Bad the Brick. Y'all don't even know the motherfucking half, okay?
Just days before his murder, Brick was also antagonizing his ops on Twitter, even calling them out for not engaging in shootouts and claiming that he was ready to walk through O-Block. However, like so often in gang life, they weren't always enemies, and one chilling photo from many years ago would actually show FBG Brick at a youth center alongside none other than McAdoo, one of the main killers in this spree of murders, who is also rumored to have possibly been the person who killed Brick. And just like with Cap, Brick had also had a history of escalating tension with McAdoo, claiming that after he had gotten shot in a previous incident, he choked McAdoo after Inky D and C-Day ran from him. Clearly this was personal, but it was also another revenge murder in the name of T-Roy. And by this point, Get Back Gang had murdered 7 people from May to July 2017, only months after T-Roy's murder. However, one man was still at the top of their hit list, the man responsible for pulling the trigger and killing T-Roy. And just 2 months later, Get Back Gang would ultimately find exactly who they were looking for.
Damn.
With his right-hand man Poppy and FBG Brick being murdered just months earlier, TB should have seen the warning signs that he was not safe in Chicago. Likely he did, but he simply couldn't leave the streets alone after having lost so many of his best friends. TB had in fact made...
I feel like that's the one that felt like you can't really leave the streets just because I feel like it's the one thing. As people adapt and people can't like really adjust and get used to like other scenery, so people are comfortable. I feel like he was comfortable where he was at. Like he knew like from the streets... Oh, you live by the gun, die by the gun, live by the streets, you die by the streets,
himself a target by bragging about his crimes on the internet and even choosing to taunt O-Block and Get Back Gang by claiming they will never get back. A brave post considering they had already killed 2 people at this point. As TB chose not to relocate in this war, sadly, eventually, it would end up catching up with him. At this point, Get Back Gang was truly looking for TB, and HK was even seen on Gyro City Skinny's Instagram Live asking for his location. HK could also be seen on social media, sliding and looking for TB with the other members. Then, on the 23rd of September, E-Dog would ominously post to Twitter saying that Get Back Gang was on the way, telling his fans, just watch what was about to happen. And on the morning of the 26th, TB shared to Facebook that he was feeling blessed. A truly chilling post, considering what would come next. Allegedly, Get Back Gang members had spent days trying to get TB's location, and much later, Lil D would even share the messages from the moment when HK seemingly found TB's location.
What?
A very incriminating post that apparently preceded the murder. At 12:45 PM, TB was with a man called Side from Gyro City.
They've been looking for him location for this long? They've been looking for it? Oh my gosh. They've been looking. So they really wanted him, and they've been trying to get his location for that long. That's
City,
crazy.
On the 7000 block of South Chapel Avenue, when someone would pull up, shooting the pair multiple times. Side was struck in the head, but thankfully survived the incident, but unfortunately TB would be less lucky. A rumor would even later circulate that upon being caught by his enemies, TB would actually smile at his attackers and say, "You got me." With this very dramatic scenario...
How do you say you got me? Remember someone on YouTube saying when he caught him, he smiled at him and said, "Now, you got me." So what, he knew or something?
Heavily disputed by followers of the Chicago drill scene, as well as individuals close to the incident. We'll probably never know exactly what was going through TB's head at that exact moment, but what we do know for certain is that TB, real name Terry Barry, was also shot in the head and later pronounced dead at Northwestern Hospital, just age 21. But a crazy coincidence is just how similar the headlines were about the murders of T-Roy and TB. Maybe the person writing these articles had a sense of irony, or perhaps more likely, it simply shows just how much the gang lifestyle ultimately ends up repeating itself. The police reports would later show just how brutal this murder was, with the autopsy showing how TB was shot so many times it was likely an entire magazine was emptied into him, and that in the police scanner audio, it was even said that they believed the shooters reloaded their guns and shot again. It's rumored that the gunmen were HK and McAdoo, with this tying a whopping 7 murders to him just in 2017 alone. The police dispatch would also spot the black vehicle that the shooter drove away in.
Be advised, victim on the porch is extremely critical.
Border black car slip, on Chappelle going the wrong way.
With them claiming that one of the shooters had a light complexion, which likely may have fit McAdoo's description.
Two males, one light complexion wearing a mask.
Indeed, the next day the duo were clearly in high spirits as they would pose together for pictures. And if these rumors are true, HK single-handedly avenged his brother T-Roy after this series of back-to-back murders following T-Roy's death. Meanwhile, TB's friends like FBG Duck would be devastated
mourning
his death. In just a few months, two of their most notable members, TB and Poppy, were killed at the hands of Get Back Gang. TB's mother would also post a heartbreaking thread to Twitter reacting to his death, and TB's schoolteacher would even post a moving article where he explained his hurt at hearing the news of his former students TB and Poppy's death, with his mother also posting her own emotional tribute to her son in the comments of that article, also calling out hateful and disrespectful comments about her son.
I mean, but he killed somebody. Oh, come on now, dog. Like, I get it, you his mom's, but if he's in the streets, I mean, you know, that's what's gonna come with being in the streets, bro. That's gonna come being in the streets, man. You know what I'm saying? And it's always our own people killing each other. I just feel like if we can just stop that, I feel like it can be a better place to live, like living them, you know. I don't know, man.
From rivals. However, unfortunately, others would lurk in the same comments, suggesting that TB himself had allegedly murdered four people, including T-Roy. TB's friends, on the other hand, would begin paying tribute to him, publicly naming him as the T-Roy Slayer, and celebrating the murder that had originally caused these brutal back-to-back killings. The extreme wave of violence that followed T-Roy's death is unheard of, even in the extremely violent reality of Chicago's gang wars. Numerous murders in broad daylight all over the span of a few months. After killing TB, O'Block was seemingly not done, and unsurprisingly, they would continue bragging to the whole world. Boss Top would make several tweets poking fun at TB's death, claiming that TB had begged for his life in a reply to one of his tweets, as well as numerous other posts, seemingly disputing the version of events where TB had been rumored to have smiled at his shooters before they got him. E-Dog from O-Block would also join in on the taunting just a day after TB's murder, posting a basketball of scoring and saying rest in peace to T-Roy. Years later, O-Block rapper Moo-Wop would diss TB extensively, saying that he's smoking on Terry Barry in his song Spin It. However, before the year would end, the cycle of violence was not finished, as HK himself would tragically lose his life to a completely separate situation in the very place that he would have thought he was the most safe.
Damn, HK. Damn, so his brother and him both lost their life in the same year, just months apart.
The 24th of November, damn, 2017, RIP, man, that's was crazy. A day like RIP. Any other in O'Block, with HK hanging out in Parkway Gardens, accompanied by Lil D and McAdoo. In the CCTV footage released from the incident, we can see the trio enter the 6436 tower block inside of Parkway Gardens. Footage would later emerge giving more context to the events that played out that day. HK and McAdoo proceeded upstairs, where they saw a man who wasn't from O'Block. Allegedly, he was just visiting somebody that he knew inside Parkway Gardens. The man was wearing gold chains, so HK and McAdoo allegedly attempted to confront and rob the man. It's possible that they didn't think this guy would fight back against such hardened and feared members affiliated with O'Block and Get Back Gang, but this turned out to be a big misjudgment. The man noticed a gun in one of their jacket pockets and would run away into one of the apartment units, closing the door after him. After HK tried to get in, the man then upped his legal firearm after yelling that he doesn't gangbang, opening fire on HK. HK was hit two times, once in the thigh, once in the abdomen. They would then retreat down the stairwell while McAdoo was blindly shooting back in the direction of the apartment unit from around the stairwell doorway. According to a witness, McAdoo then attempted to get HK down the stairs and out of the building, but eventually bailed on his attempt to help HK, which explains why many online believe that McAdoo left HK for dead. Meanwhile, police responded to calls of shots fired within Parkway Gardens, and when they arrived, they were informed that HK, real name Hakeem Murray, had suffered several gunshot wounds. HK was transported to the Northwestern Hospital, where he was pronounced dead at 8:53 p.m. Somehow,
tried to rob somebody and it was a failed attempt. I feel like if McAdoo would have helped him, he'd probably still be alive now, but damn, bro.
The killer would make it out of the building and escape to another apartment complex on South Michigan, where he stashed his gun. Later, he would agree to an interview by police and told them everything, whilst also handing them the gun he used to kill HK, which indeed matched the shell casings recovered at the scene. The man would even identify HK as the man who shot him from an ID parade. With that and other evidence from the crime scene, it would turn out to be a fairly clear case of self-defense, and the shooter was able to walk free under the mutual combatants law. In the same year, both brothers T-Roy
in this case, his brother T-Roy, they might try to come get you. Even if it's self-defense, you know, sometimes it's self-defense, they don't care just because you killed their homie and their partner. you killed, you know, some people that was in the gang that put in work. But at the end of the day, that's self-defense. Like, if he said he didn't gangbang, he had a legal firearm, he just visited somebody from Old Black, I mean,
HK that's self-defense, to gun man. Violence.
I'll repeat that, man.
It would be a twisted irony that after all of the murders that he had committed in his brother's name, it would end up being a complete stranger that would end up taking the life of O'Block's supposed headshot king. But HK's death was not the end of the fallout following T-Roy's murder, as O'Block was seemingly not done with their getbacks, and still had their sights on yet another man involved in the murder of T-Roy, with that person being the second man who was there during the murder, Man-Man, better known as Get Right, Tugan.
So they really got everybody? That was involved in that T-Roy thing. Man,
also known as Get
so
Right.
You're telling me the Get Back Gang thing started because of T-Roy passed away? That's
Get
crazy.
Right was TB's accomplice in the slaying of T-Roy. And just like TB, he likely knew it wasn't safe for him to be outside, considering the amount of murders that O'Block and Get Back Gang had carried out the previous summer. Around 9:50 p.m., Man-Man was standing outside of a store, waiting for food on the 400 block of E63rd, a location that's just a stone's throw away from O'Block, but very much Man-Man.
Look how close that is. How close that is to them right here. That is crazy.
Man's own territory. Suddenly, a car pulled up, and when Man-Man was spotted, two shooters would hop out, running towards him, opening fire. In the gruesome CCTV footage from the murder, we can see how Man-Man was initially hit before he would try and make an escape. But he would then be gunned down on the floor, with the shooters firing more shots, standing over him, to ensure that he was dead. Unfortunately, they didn't even stop there. But they would also end up shooting an innocent bystander, a 43-year-old janitor, Troy Hampton, who was just doing his job sweeping up outside of the store, and the whole incident would indeed be caught on CCTV camera, where you can even see one of the gunmen purposely aiming at the man and firing several times. Commenters on Reddit would share their disgust at this bold double murder.
Morning are looking for the gunman who killed two men overnight. They were standing outside of a store in the city's Woodlawn neighborhood
they
when someone started shooting. A 43-year-old man was shot in the chest. He died at the hospital. The other victim, a 22-year-old, also died. Police say the 22-year-old is a known gang member and was the intended target.
The only way I can see them killing the other man was because maybe a witness. I don't know, but come on, dog. He's just doing his job, bro. I see, this is why innocent bystanders can literally get killed too and get shot. Sometimes they're doing the work, they don't know what's they're just doing their work, bro. That's some life, bro. Come on.
Following the murder of Man-Man, Chiracologists would begin to theorize just who could have potentially carried out this brutal assassination. Surprisingly, many in the community believed that one of the shooters could have been the infamous Chicago gangster dubbed the Gravedigger of Chirac, Po51 Melly. The rumors of hatred between the two had begun after a viral video circulated from Poppy's balloon release following his funeral. And in the clip, Man-Man can be seen dropping the Y, a disrespectful hand sign towards 051 Young Money, doing this in front of the camera and right in front of Melly, with the camera then panning to Melly.
Damn, so Melly, oh my, there's no way he dropped his what, gang or something, what it was called?
In the clip, Man-Man can be seen dropping the Y, a disrespectful hand sign towards 051 Young Money, doing this in front of the camera and right in front of Melly, with the camera then panning to Melly, showing his shocked reaction, which even gets a nervous laugh out of FBG Duck, who is in attendance. The comments on YouTube would mention how this could have been a grave mistake, leading Melly to want to kill Man-Man. But these rumors have since been debunked by members of STL, after FBG Young participated in an Ask Me Anything thread for the Chiracology subreddit in 2022, denying Melly was responsible for the incident, but indeed admitting that STL do not chill with 051, but still paying homage to Melly. For many, there was no need to theorize, as it seemed very clear which gang was responsible for this murder. When assessing the highlights from the police scanners in the area after the shooting, it would actually appear that STL began shooting back at O'Block almost instantly after the hit. Police officers arrived at the scene at 9:50 p.m, and just 20 minutes later, loud reports of gunshots were heard at 64th and King Drive, the heart of Parkway Gardens. Around 40 minutes later, more shots were reported fired in the area, with shell casings being found this time. In the next hour, more shots were fired, and casings were found by police. Clearly, SDL, aka Tukaville, had attempted to slide and retaliate on O'Block right away. Members of O'Block also took to the internet as usual, and left many braggadocious clues about the murder. The very next day, King Von himself would actually go live with several O'Block members beginning to mock Man-Man's.
The thing is, how does some of them live like this? I live like this. Knowing you try to go get some food at a chicken spot or a food spot over here, and your ops can literally know you come boom, 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 come shoot it up, bro. How do y'all live like that? Y'all can't even go to school, do nothing. Like, this is...
Death, making a joke out of his other name, Get Right, or Can't Get Right, calling him Can't Get Up.
There you go. Can't get right. There you go.
Can't get right,
because
I can't get right.
All right, hey, everybody, not at one time. What just happened?
Dave, you know...
What just happened?
A lot of glitches and effort.
You right there with your hand. You tell me who got killed. That's what I'm asking y'all. Who got killed, gang?
Yeah.
Can't get right, got killed.
Merge. Can't get right, got
killed. And somebody show me a picture. I don't think I know y'all talking about. Is this can't get
Is that can't get right?
Hold on, is this him?
Is this
can't
get right?
This ain't called snitching. I'm just trying to get verified. You give me verification. They tell some can't get up. Oh,
they always make some shit before we do it. They beat us to it every time.
Y'all should start killing people.
Oh,
if y'all be doing this, you be doing the name.
Oh, Steve.
The group would even mock the death of the innocent janitor, claiming that they will have to roll another one, seemingly unaware that the second victim of the shooting was indeed an innocent man.
They said two down. Damn.
Two men is that? Nah, I can't
on
take
On David,
two.
They said it on two. Both our lives.
I could barely take
two
beats.
Two beats? I can take one. Somebody roll another one.
Can't.
Whoever else got hit.
They would then continue, reacting to their ops posting tributes to Man-Man.
They talking can't get up. Like, bro, what?
Damn, best friend, you just told me to pop out. I remember back in the days when you just told me to pop out, best friend. Why the f*** you do me like this? You bogus as hell.
They ain't try to.
They gonna be dissing you better not get
Von and his crew would then begin making more direct disses at the situation, claiming that STL stands for steady taking losses, and that the FN gave him a fresh fade like Lil Boosie.
Steady taking losses.
STL,
what
the fuck? Steady taking losses. Motherfucker gave him a fresh fade, Boosie
Boosie.
Hey, why didn't they even put him on Front Street like he was even like that, though?
Von would then add that he probably knew he was gonna die and that no one will care he's gone.
He probably knew he was gonna die.
It is.
I wish I could talk to him. Don't nobody even care about can't get right like that. I don't think they gonna slide like that. I don't think nothing finna happen because of that, so.
They finna waste the rest of their money on that.
We ain't even gonna act like nothing finna happen. Just y'all going to the house.
Gotta pay for
whoever ain't get shot, you lucky today. Finna go in the house. It's over.
They would even continue to self-incriminate, detailing how the hit probably played out and poking fun at how Man-Man was hit, trying to run away, and how he couldn't move.
And then this is how they get caught. They be sitting there self-stitching on themselves or their partner. Like, what? That's how half of them get locked up, because they be sitting there self-stitching or self-stitching on their little game members, on their homies.
But the self-snitching didn't stop there, because just 2 weeks after that murder, King Von would famously tweet, "Shout out to that new op pack, my brothers made it." King Von even took the disses into his music. In his Bless the Booth freestyle, he would rap, "He tried to run, but it ain't end right. They call him Can't Get Right." E-Dog from O-Block would also chime in, first posting to Twitter that the get back is not over, and then, 3 days later, posting, "Your ass better get right or get left." Members of STL have even admitted that O-Block were responsible for this murder. In 2021, FBG Young was interviewed by Truth Teller TV. When Young is questioned about an FBG Duck lyric regarding Man-Man or Get Right picking up food, Young replies, explaining that a lot has happened on his block, but continuing to explain that a lot of stuff happened in their neighborhood, and it's different because they're on blocks and people from O-Block are in a gated community.
Some of you was getting some food. You know what I'm talking about in the song Thug Angels, okay? That happened right on the corner of y'all neighborhood.
I don't know if you ever seen the store, like the restaurant. It's like it was a restaurant at the time. It's a store now. It's like on 63rd between Everhard and Vernon. So it's like, it's not like a corner, but it's like on the front street of the busy street, 63rd.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, in the neighborhood.
A lot of shit happened in that neighborhood. I mean, a lot of shit happened in that neighborhood. It's like different, cause like, we own blocks, and they like in the gay community.
Right.
As usual, internet sleuths would begin investigating who the gunmen were, with many of them landing on two prospective O-Block members in particular, Moowop and Duke. One of the massive hints at the two being the shooters was Moowop's ominous post following the murder, where he says people wouldn't know the type of bond that him and Duke have, with the top comment clearly understanding the reference. Moreover, in an unreleased snippet from Moowop,
they really gotta get back for that. That's crazy. like 2018, I mean 2017.
He would rap Duke like King Kong, man. Standing over people in their own hood, seemingly describing the exact circumstances of Man Man's death. Muwop would post further hints at the pair's possible involvement after Duke was arrested for a separate incident, writing, "You get the right, I got the left, we going to meet back up." And soon after, Duke was actually shot at, but luckily he survived with only minor leg injuries. But even more shocking is just how deep the theories get that Muwop was the shooter on that original hit, with many people arguing that Muwop actually has a distinctive gait, a style of walking and running that's actually very unique and easy to identify, as clips of him running in O'Block, as well as surveillance footage that came out years later during the trial where he was convicted of the murder of FBG Duck, with one poster on Reddit even doing a gait analysis, theorizing that Muwop's run perfectly matched the shooter in the Get Right case. Ultimately, this particular murder was never solved, and despite the rumors, nobody knows definitively who killed Man Man. Once Man Man had passed, along with TB, both of the people who had killed T-Roy had lost their lives. However, the damage was done. O'Block would lose T-Roy's brother HK in a completely random incident, and despite the supposed goal of Get Back Gang being achieved, the Get Backs would indeed never stop. Numerous people from both sides would go on to lose their lives, including the most prominent rapper from STL, FBG Duck, and the most prominent person to come out of O'Block, King Von himself, who also ended up being shot dead in a freak incident that nobody could have predicted. But in many ways, the way that King Von died fit the exact characteristics of the sort of murders that him and his Get Back Gang committed. Whether Get Back Gang truly believes that they avenged T-Roy or not, the senseless cycle of violence and trauma can't be ignored. Those members choosing to go on a series of killings will never be able to bring back T-Roy, and their activities in the streets would only amount to more lives lost to murder or prison. Sadly, for everybody involved, even to this very day, no winners can really be identified. The King of O'Block, T-Roy's best friend King Von, is dead, and many of the original and most important members that celebrated Get Back Gang's murders are facing lifetimes in jail or dead too. Countless families have lost
their lives. Bro, ain't nobody winners, bro. Most of the people that in the Chicago scene that lost their life is either dead, serving like 25 years in life. That's it. Either in jail or serving 25 years of life. That's it. Now you still got G Herbo, Lil Durk and them. They still surviving, but they still got their ops. You know what I'm saying? There's no more FBG Duck. So he can't even like, there's, bro, this shit, ain't nobody winning to this shit, man. Who was the winner? Nobody.
You wonder, what is it all for? I personally pray that one day we as a society can find a solution to the never-ending violence in these communities. And the first step towards that is reflecting and understanding. So I want to end by making it very clear. This story does not intend to glorify or glamorize the gang lifestyle in any way. There are clearly no winners here. But if you or somebody you love has lost a loved one to the gun and are thinking about Get Backs, I urge you from the bottom of my heart, think again. Get Backs, revenge and violence never truly heal the loss of a loved one. Life is precious, and I bet that if you could speak to any of the people who lost their lives in this story, innocent or otherwise, they would simply wish that they had taken a different and more positive chance. Because if you're sat there today with your life and your freedom intact, you still have a chance to make a change. Do something positive and leave the world and your community a better place than it was when you came into it. Otherwise, you're just doomed to join the others who chose violence and Get Backs in a jail cell or the unknown of what comes after life. You've only got one life, and I beg you make the most of it. I hope you found that story interesting. And despite all of...
Hey, man, shout out to Chandler Ross, man. This is a good documentary, good by him, bro. So it was really good, man. Let me know what you think down below, man. I just think nobody's really winners in this, man. They all lost their life. And it's just really sad, man. From Duck, from KI, from Brick, from Duck, from Vaughn, from T-Roy, from HK, bro. All of them, bro. From OD, bro. All of them, bro. Like, what's the point? Like, now this scene is gone no more, bro. It just is like a ghost town now, bro. Everybody is gone, man. And I feel like if they're like still alive today, I really feel like they say, oh yeah, that wasn't worth it, man. I feel like once you grow up and you mature, you realize, oh man, the shit I did back in my when I was young and the same wasn't really worth it. But hey, man, that's it for documentary, man. Thank y'all for watching, man. I'll see you guys later, man. I'm out.